What's going on, internet? Jossie Joss here, and I have a box for you today. It's been a bit since I've had a box. I think all of them are starting to finally ship, and since it is now January, most of the hiatuses that I took from boxes to save money for the holidays, they should be done. So hypothetically, I should be getting everything this month that should be coming in for the month of January. So for today, I have a tasting and unboxing for you. It is the January 2017 Universal Yums box. One of my favorite boxes. It's really fun just to travel the world via snack, since traveling the world's kind of, you know, not terribly expensive, but it's just time. It takes time and planning and all that stuff. So let's get into it. Oh, whoa, this is new. So, sorry, I'm hearing things in the background, but normally there's like tissue paper, but they got a full-on like printed card here. It says, "Welcome to Ukraine." So that's what we're dealing with for the month of January, Ukraine. So, it looks like they've replaced the tissue paper, which I guess is a good thing, with this cool little cardboardy thingy. And it has a scoreboard for all the snacks, and there's a map so you can see where the Ukraine is on the map, which I would probably fail. This totally reminds me of, does anybody remember watching old school Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego? And if you made it to the final round, you got to run around some ginormous map and put down these siren like pole thingies to each either country or state. And yeah, it was always tough when they got to like Eastern Europe or Africa, because it's like you don't remember the shape of those countries, especially when they're really small and close together. At least with the United States maps, you had a chance because there's only 50 of them, compared to Africa and Eastern Europe, and they have like outrageous names. So, but that's what that map reminds me of. And there's also like a puzzle. So, it's kind of like, if you guys remember the jumble in the newspaper, you basically try to figure out the word, and then it has selected letters to create another word, and that answers this, whatever that is on the bottom. So, it's okay, I don't need to do all of that, that's a lot. But, we are in the Ukraine, or we are, the box has Ukrainian snacks in it. So it's another full year of yums, and so I'm not gonna go over the paragraph. I mean, it just, they're basically wishing you a happy new year. So let's do the Ukraine trivia. Trivia is always fun. Try to see if I can answer all the questions. Number one, Ukraine became independent from Russia after which historical event? The A, the end of World War I in 1918, B, the end of the Ukrainian War of Independence in 1921, C, the end of World War II in 1945, D, the fall of the Soviet Union in 1991. I believe it is D, the fall of the Soviet Union in 1991, because honestly, I had never heard of the Ukraine until that time. And I was a kid, I was in school, and learning geography was just one of those things, and that happened. It's a trick question. Universal Yums, how dare you? It's B and D. So it says, Ukraine was an independent state in 1918 and fell under Russia rule again until 1991, when it finally secured independence again. Tricky. All right. Number two, the capital of Ukraine is A, Kiev, B, Crimea, C, Lviv, D, Warsaw. I know it's not D because Warsaw is in Poland. I've been there. I've been to Warsaw, so ha. I'm going to say Kiev, A. Yay! Kiev is the capital of Ukraine and the nation's largest city. Crimea is a region, not a city, and Lviv, L-V-I-V, is the fourth largest city in Ukraine. Warsaw is the capital of Poland. Haha, I knew that. Number three, what political party actually exists in Ukraine? A, the Red Party, B, the Birthday Party, that sounds fun, C, the American Party, D, the Internet Party. Red Party? The Internet Party? Real? The Internet Party in Ukraine wants to create an electronic government in Ukraine that exists without bureaucracy and paperwork. I hate paperwork, so I'm all for that. That's just funny, though. Although I really would like a birthday party. Just joking. Whatever. Anyway, number four. How can you tell if someone is married in Ukraine? A, they have a small tattoo on their left ring finger. B, they wear a ring on their right ring finger. C, they wear a bracelet on their left wrist. D, you can't. B, A. Ukrainians wear wedding bands on their right hand, unlike the US, where we wear them on our left. Okay, that's interesting. So this is what our little box of snacks looks like for this month. Ukrainian snacks. Again, this is going to be very similar to the Russia box where I cannot pronounce or read anything. So we're just going to go through and just try to find things. Macho Forest mushroom chips. I think it's this one. There's mushrooms on it. Mushroom hunting is common pastime in Ukraine, with people gathering mushrooms from local parks and forests to use in a variety of Ukrainian dishes. All right. Croissant croissant with mochaccino filling. You might go to a coffee shop for a mochaccino and a croissant. Have you ever gone to a coffee shop for a mochaccino croissant? No. This is a rare hybrid of drink and snack. Okay. Sounds tasty. I'm always down for croissants. Croissant's one of my favorite breads ever. Ooh. Mmm. Macho bacon peanuts. Had a rough day. These are the perfect snack to wash down with a nice cold beer or water. No pressure. After the first few bites, the bacon flavor mellows out and you're left with the ultimate salty snack. Bacon peanuts. That's a new one. It's kind of like that, was a German snack that had the peanut puff with the spice, like the Mexican spice. It's like a weird combo. Maybe it'll work out in that way. Red caviar bread snacks. What is that? Caviar is typically thought of as a dish for the super rich. That's okay, we can pretend to be rich for a day. To properly eat the world's most expensive food, there's a lot of work required. Okay, blah, 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 blah. I don't care about all of this. Or you can just eliminate the expense and settle for this fancy caviar snack instead. It's a caviar snack, the toast. I think I remember some of the Russian weird toasty things from that box, and I was not a fan of those. Not a fan. So it was like weird meat gel or something. I don't know, maybe. Let's do the candy thing. So, peach yogurt milk chocolate bar. Interesting. That's a funky combo. The company that makes this chocolate's very, very old. It's one of the oldest companies in Ukraine. It opened up in 1882. Wow. And there's a huge, ginormous paragraph about work and stuff and things and everything. But this just sounds interesting. Peach and yogurt and chocolate, that's a funky combo. There's a bunch of candies in here. Like they always do, they kind of bunch all the candies in a little packet so that it doesn't get lost in shipping, which I think is a really good idea. But for these cases, it's kind of hard. I don't want to rip these open, but there's a thing called Crazy Bee Candy, if I can find it. These yellow ones are here on the bottom. If you like Gushers, you love these. Every super chewy piece is filled with a real fruit liquid filling. What's not clear, why are they called crazy bees? There's no honey in them, and we don't think bees like fruit candy. It says you'd be crazy to be sharing these. That's why they're called crazy bees. It says you'll see four of the following flavors. Sour cherry, tropical orange, wild strawberry, lemon lime, pink grapefruit, or sweet cranberry. I don't know what flavors they are, because I can't read the labels. All right. This is Who said new? New. The water. This is a wafer that is stuffed with sweet milk cream filling covered in milk chocolate drizzle. Interesting. So it's like, yeah, so you can see the picture. It's like a wafer with like cream and stuff in the middle of it. So that sounds really yummy. Cool. Right, I think that's everything from these pages. Sour cream with herbs breadstick. So the previous one was caviar. This is sour cream. Apparently, Ukraine is nicknamed the breadbasket of Europe, and it's because it's one of the leading producers of grain in Europe and even the entire world. So they eat a lot of it, and a lot of times they'll eat it with a thin layer of mayonnaise. That's just weird. I mean, mayo is okay, but I don't know if just straight up bread and mayo. You gotta put like some like cold cuts or cheese or something on top of that. And they talk about like tradition about not leaving bread on the floor and some other things. All right, next. What is it? This thing. These orange Orororo. Apricot and cream bonbons. Apricots are a popular filling in Ukrainian dishes. They're used in cakes, drinks, jellies, and the inside of dumplings, and of course, eaten raw. And they prefer to eat in these gorgeous wafer cookies stuffed with apricot cream. Apricot. That's a flavor that I don't get a lot. Roshan creme brulee chocolate bar. Boom. Roshan. Roshan, it's Ukraine's most famous candy company, started in 1996 by a businessman named Petro Poroshenko. And so Roshan is taken from his name. Cool. That just sounds good. I mean, it's chocolate and creme brulee filling. How can that not be delicious? Let's see, another one. Sivoch. Charvoni mak candy. I think it's this one. That one right there. Calling all chocolate lovers, we found your ultimate chocolate fix. This rich, deep, flavorful chocolate will fulfill all your cravings. But behind the sweet is a bittersweet story. Oh, wow. So on the wrapper of these candies, there's a red flower. It's a red poppy flower. And the red poppy flower is used in the Ukraine as a remembered symbol, specifically to memorialize servicemen who have died in war. Oh, so that's kind of sad. So it's like in memoriam. That's kind of a cool thing, though. Interesting. That's chocolate candy. Then they have this thing called glass of milk caramels. I don't know what they look like, but I'm assuming they're in here somewhere. Maybe this white with the blue. They said you have to try a glass of milk candy. It's a candy with a thick creamy milk filling. It's a really long description on like why they added it to the box, but I'm like, I don't really want to read it right now. Next one is, I think it's this one right here, this the one with the black and yellow. Velvet Night Bar Cut Nochi Chocolates. Move over forever to share. There's another decadent hazelnut chocolate on the market. It looks like our giant Hershey's Kiss. Oh, okay, so yeah, see, like hazelnut in the middle of it. It does remind me of Hershey's Kiss. Actually, Hershey has those like deluxe Hershey Kisses now that has like the hazelnut inside of it. It's like their version of the Ferrero Rocher. So, and then on the bottom they have these Fizzy Boom hard candies, which is these. We need to say something to Ukraine, so we wrote a letter. So fizzy fruity candy. It's a fizzy fruity candy. It's Universal Yums being Universal Yums. They're just singing like a poem to the country. And that is all that is in the box for Ukraine. So there's a whole slew of things about Ukrainian art, which is kind of fun, including recently Starbucks cups. It says, if you're a fan of coffee, you'll recognize this design. This year, a Ukrainian-born artist named Anna Bucchiarelli won Starbucks contest to design one of the 13 cups. She used the traditional Petrikivka style folk art for her winning design. So if you've been to Starbucks during the holiday season, you remember they had a bunch of, they had 13 different designs for the holiday cups. One of the artists was Ukrainian, so that's really, really awesome. And also there is a recipe for a Ukrainian breakfast. Vareniki. It's a similar to Polish pierogies. They're a staple of Ukrainian cuisine. And I like pierogies. I had some really good ones in Poland when I went, so that's really cool. And then there's a list of cool places to visit Ukraine or an explore. And of course the music playlist. All right. I'm trying to figure out what I want to try. Honestly, I don't know if I want to try anything sweet today. I think I might just do all the savory things. So just for save on time, because it take me, these videos, I noticed these videos take way too long, and they take way too long to compress and then put online. So I'm trying to limit the amount of time I spend. So I'm gonna do the four savory items and probably the croissant. So the big items, basically the big items. So I'm scared. The red caviar thing scares me. So I think I should just do that first and get out of the way. And then take a break and do the peanut. And then do the sour cream. And then do the mushroom. And then end with the croissant. Alright. So, let's start off with this. This is red caviar. I am not a fan of caviar. I mean, like, salmon roe and sushi? Yeah. Doesn't really have a fishy smell. Looks like little toast stick thingies. Oh, but the flavor. It's not terrible, but it's not wonderful either. It's a flavor that grows on me. The more I'm eating it, the more mellow the flavor gets. It's not as strong, like the fishy flavor. Okay. Not as terrible as I thought it was going to be. That's a good sign. All right. Next, I'm gonna try the Macho Bacon Peanut. Excuse me. This is gonna be interesting. Those toasts that I just had, very dry though. That's, not a fan of that, but. Smells like peanuts. Looks like a peanut. Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So. Wow. They weren't kidding when that bacon flavor kind of like, pew, cuts in front of the peanut. But I'll make a statement saying, hey, I'm bacon. But then it mellows out as you continue to eat. But very smoky. And it works with the peanut. I like these. I like them a lot. Now, if you're not used to it, that bacon flavor is just gonna punch you in the face. But as you eat it, it mellows itself out, and it's good. Nice. A little salty, though. That's a little thing. A little salty. Alright. The other toast. This is the sour cream one. These smell like... Have you ever had like sour cream potato chips? That's what they smell like. Oh, these are much better. This reminds me of those sour cream and herb potato chips. But instead of potato, it's bread. A little salty. But... I like this one a lot. Obviously, I like this one more than the red caviar one. But so far, so good. I'm like... I might actually finish that bag on my own. Alright. Next. And then those mushroom chips? Potato chips? Something like that. Looks innocent enough. Decent potato chip. Not too salty, which is good because the last one I had was pretty salty. That was a big chip. The mushroom flavor is very subtle. It's there, but I can mostly taste potato, which I guess is a good thing because it is a potato chip. But good. Not as good as the toasts, but still good. Better than the red caviar thing. Alright. I'm gonna end my tasting video by trying this croissant thing. The It's supposed to be a croissant stuffed with like a mochaccino. From any with like a sweet, desserty type thing. Smells good. Looks like a little croissant. Okay. I haven't gotten to the filling yet. But tastes like a nice sweet pastry. There's the filling. It's all uneven. They're filled with machines, so can't really see how you're filling, but there's the filling. Not bad. That's actually really good.
Sorry about that. My phone ran out of storage, so I had to go through and delete a bunch of stuff, so the video is gonna be all weird at that moment. But still finishing up this croissant thingy. Good.
Very good. So, there's a bunch of candy and stuff in there too from Ukraine. I'll probably eventually try it. It's just for the sakes of this video, especially with my phone being the way it is, these terrible unboxing videos, I'm probably gonna have to cut it shorter than I usually do, but that's fine. But overall, what I've had, even the red caviar thing, wasn't terrible.
I mean, I could probably eat it. I don't know if I'd buy it myself, but if someone had, you know, that out at their house or something, or offer it to me to eat, I would munch on it. That's fine. But for what I've tried overall, this was obviously the croissant thing was amazing. It didn't really taste like mochaccino filling. It just tasted like a chocolate, like a very light chocolate mousse. But the pastry was very light and very like sweet and just perfect. So that definitely recommend for sure. Of the other items, I like the sour cream bread thingy toast things. This one, whatever. I like those the most, but overall, they weren't terrible, and I would eat them again. So way to go, Ukraine. You got some flavor in you. That's awesome. So now, we've come part of the video where we try to figure out where we're going next month. So clue to next month's box. Ditch the horoscope. Because we can already say that you'll fall in love soon with yums on the way. Orange cookies, anise candies, and tiramisu, their Cibo, C-I-B-O, is so easy to love, you won't want to share with your boo. Tiramisu. Well, tiramisu's Italian, so they're going to Italy? Possibly. If not Italy, somewhere else in the Mediterranean, that where they have that orange cookies and anise candies, so, or something that's exposed to that type of stuff. I say Italy, but I don't know. Anyway, that is all from me, and that is all from the January 2017 Universal Yums box featuring snacks from the Ukraine. If this looks like a box that you guys might be interested in subscribing to, I'll go ahead and put information in the description below. I'll also probably put the recipe that I mentioned that was inside of the booklet as well, just because it's cool to have recipes and stuff available. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And again, I apologize for that random break in the middle because I ran out of space. and if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel. I have a whole bunch of other unboxing videos on there for you and tasting videos. I'm working on trying to consolidate my tasting videos to a shorter amount of time, so please let me know what you think, or if I shouldn't try snacks at all on camera, because I tend to talk about food a lot, so just let me know. That's what the comments are for, but please be civil. Thank you. That's it. Thank you for your support thus far. Thank you for watching, and have a great night, everyone. Bye.